beginning of the year, we heard from Marching and Seth McGowan, who were in studio talking about their wee son, Dahi. Dahi's three. And you remember he was the subject of a BBC documentary called Cree Brisha, or Broken Heart, about how he was waiting for a heart transplant. Well, Marching is on the line. Hiya, Marching.
How's it going, John? Are you keeping well?
I'm not too bad at all. You're very welcome to the programme. Remind people who maybe didn't hear you the first time, remind us of Dahi's story.
Well, Dahi was born with a severe congenital heart defect called hypoplastic left heart syndrome, and it basically means that he was born with half a working heart. Normally, there's a series of three operations that a condition like this is treated with, but Dahi has had two operations, and he's been ruled out of the third operation, which basically means that that his only option at the minute is the gift of a new heart. He's passed the 2 year mark on the wait list. And as you said there, the BBC followed us for 18 months of that journey. Put together a fantastic half hour documentary or a
brilliant programme. And it's still there on the iPlayer. It's still there if you want to watch it. It's called Cree
Bristol. It's still available, and
you've been watching it in lockdown, have you?
Dahi actually says a lot, I wanna watch me on TV, he says. And we watch it every couple of days, believe it or not. And do you know what it is? There are parts in it that are very sad, but there are parts in it that are also very hopeful as well. So, you know, Dahi actually knows what words are coming next sometimes.
How's he doing in lockdown, Martin?
I can't believe I'm going to say this, but he's never been actually better. He had this cough for the best part of a year, really, you know, on and off. And, you know, just with us being on total lockdown and Dahi shielding, he hasn't been around anybody. And he's just shitting there that he's in Nanny's caravan. So he's in great form, you know. So it's the biggest thing for him really is not really understanding what lockdown is and why he's not allowed to be around his cousins and his friends and going to school. And it's been a really difficult few months.
I imagine he's particularly vulnerable.
Yeah, well, that's it. We're in constant contact with his, you know, with his cardiac nurses and his community nurses, and they were delighted to hear from us, you know, that we weren't going out and we weren't taking any risks, especially with his SATs being so low that all the machines you hear about that we've heard about around coronavirus, you know, the ventilators and the ECMO machines and the intensive care stays, you know, Dahi's been there, and we just didn't want to take any risk at all. And I think as nurses were really happy to hear that we weren't taking any risks.
And for all the severity of his case, Martin, he's still not top of the queue for a transplant.
No, well, that's it. You know, it's a weird one, really, because, you know, Dahi's stable and he's doing really well, and but that kind of rules him out of being, you know, bumped up at the top of the list. But it is a good thing, because they always say when we're in Newcastle, it's, you know, it's getting as much use out of his current heart, his native heart, as they call it, you know, as possible, because a heart transplant, as sad as it is, a heart transplant is really only time, and it's what time you get out of a heart transplant if it's successful. So the best thing to do really is for his own heart to be beaten for as long as it will.
And you and Seth have been using your time during lockdown to keep campaigning away about organ donations.
Well, that's it. You know, campaigning has, you know, it could have just gone to the wall, really. We couldn't really do anything, but we've made the most of it. We've reached out to people to try and help us, you know, create awareness of organ donation, and we've managed to encourage people to join the organ donor register. And during lockdown as well, we'd seen that England had actually officially changed to a soft opt-out approach, which was bringing in Max and Kier's law, which basically means that you're considered to be an organ donor unless you opt out. So we were able to use that to create some noise here. And, you know, we've been in touch with politicians. And just before the lockdown came in, actually, we were due to meet Minister Robin Swan. We're meeting with Robin Swan on the 19th of August via Zoom. We're still keeping the pressure on. We're still working, you know, with the British Heart Foundation. We're still trying our best to keep the pressure on, you know. But I suppose we do have to be very careful, because it is a very hard time for some families. You know, a lot of people have been lost during this time. But, you know, with the transplant services being reduced, what's going to happen is that when we come out of this, we're expecting maybe Dahi's wait to be even longer now. So that's why we're upping the approach.
Donate for Dahi, D-A-I-T-H-I, if you want to find out more. Would he say hello?
Dahi, you want to say hello? Come on. Oh, he's saying no.
No.
Come on over. Who's playing tonight?
Hiya, Dahi.
He's going to watch Liverpool and City tonight, he says.
Dahi, are you a Liverpool fan?
Yeah.
Are you? Who's your favourite Liverpool player? Mo Salah. He's amazing, isn't he?
Do you want to sing the Mo Salah song?
Yeah.
What's sing the Mo Salah song?
What's the Mo Salah song? I don't know it.
Mo Salah. He's just singing her I Love Liverpool in Irish.
That's amazing. Ain't a Meyer fad. They need him on the bus whenever they have the big homecoming thing.
Well, we're actually invited over to the Crystal Palace game.
No way.
On the 9th, I think it was the 19th of March, or the way it worked out is that's the game where they would have won the league, and we were invited over, but coronavirus had other ideas.
Do you know what? Still good enough to win the league. Listen, Fishy Shin Harbar, thanks a million for doing that, Martin, and thank you, Mila Buihis, to Dahi as well. He's going to be 4 in October, isn't that right?
He'll be 4 in October, yep. So it's another big milestone, hopefully.
Absolutely. Well, if you want to see the programme again, Cree Brischa, it's called, and it's still on the BBC iPlayer. Thanks a million. Stay safe and talk to you soon, hopefully.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
That's Martin McGowan and wee Dahi, who's 3, but nearly 4, and clearly a big Liverpool fan. Love it to bits.